If you're looking to boost your Mutt team or make some money by selling coins, check out MobileMaddenCoins.com. Use code CLIQUID at checkout for a 10% discount. Hey, what is going on, guys? CLIQUID here, back again with another Madden 16 Draft Champions video. Guys, today what we're going to be doing is something kind of more fun, I think. Something a little bit challenging to me. A lot of you know when I play Madden, I typically kind of... I basically always look for speed. Like, it's almost the most important thing that I look at pretty much regardless of position. So what we're gonna do today is actually do the exact opposite of that. I'm gonna challenge myself. We're gonna go ahead and actually pick the slowest player every round. So this is gonna be quite a bit of a challenge to me. It could be the highest overall player on the board, so that could be helpful, but the bottom line is I'm not gonna have a lot of speed on this roster, so that's gonna be a little bit challenging to me. Now, the one rule that I will say is that if I've already got a player at a position, let's say like offensive line or something like that, and the slowest player is a player at the position that I already have, I'm not going to select that player just because, you know, I don't want to only have offensive line because that would be, you know, just ridiculous to try and compete with, not to mention the fact that, of course, I wouldn't even get to take advantage of other positions. So, again, if I have that already, we're not going to pick that position. But other than that, we're pretty much going to pick the slowest player every single round. So, with that being said, guys, let's get into this thing. First thing, I guess we'll pick just the slowest coach. Jim Tomsula looks like he's probably pretty slow, so we'll go ahead and pick that. Now, I have never played the 49ers playbook that I can remember, so that's probably going to be a challenge in and of itself, but we'll see what we can do here. Now, starting off here with Auryan Matthews, but we've got a center on the board. Obviously, I'm pretty sure he's going to be the slowest. 62 speed, quite a bit slower than Darren Fells or Auryan Matthews, so we're starting it off strong with a freaking center. Probably the worst offensive line position, the one that I care the least about. Back now to another offensive lineman. I think it's going to be offensive lineman for the most part to start things off here. But, you know, hopefully we can, pick up from here. 84 speed for Harry Douglas. That would be pretty slow typically. But, yeah, we're going to start off with Spain. So, all right, let's get the offensive lineman out of the way with the gold cards. All right, so it's definitely not going to be Ted Ginn Jr. considering he's 95 speed. Justin Houston's pretty quick at an 82. I have no idea about Derek Shelby. It looks like he's an 85 speed, so I wish I could actually try this card. This looks like it's a pretty decent card, but we'll go with base Justin Houston. That's actually not that bad. It could be a lot worse for a left outside linebacker, so I'm actually kind of happy about that. Now we go on here. It looks like we're probably going to be going with, it could be Donald Penn. We've already got a center, so it's not going to be Travis Frederick, although he would be the slowest at a 54 speed. Sheesh. But we've got 63 speed here and 60 speed here with Mike Yapati. So, hey, we at least get an elite offensive lineman in a round where we could have ended up with a left tackle that's a gold. But, we've got, three offensive linemen so far? That's not good. Defensive lineman, maybe. Come on. Please be slower, Haloti Ngata. I know you're not fast. 68 speed. Oh no, Will Beatty is 65 speed. We're probably going to have to go with him. We've already got a center. So, all right, there we go. We're getting four of the five offensive lineman positions out of the way already. What, we're six rounds in. Sheesh. All right. Come on now. All right, so now we're on defensive side of the ball, and it's almost certainly going to be Sheldon Richardson. He's one of the slowest defensive ends in this game, and he's 70 speed. Nigel Bradham, I know, is quick at an 88, and of course, Lawrence Timmons is... You know, he's slow, actually, for a middle linebacker, but still not anywhere near as slow as Sheldon Richardson. Okay, now we get a sweet round. We get a signature round. Definitely like that. Reggie Bush at a 93 speed. That actually might be the slowest. I think it probably is the slowest because we've got Andre Johnson here. Nope, 92 speed for Andre Johnson. That's a pretty good card, though. That Andre Johnson is actually really nice. And then Isaac Bruce being a 94 speed, I assume that he was going to be the quickest of the bunch. But that's actually not too bad. I'm okay with getting Andre Johnson here. I'm actually pretty happy about that. That's a pretty good round for me when we're going for the slowest player. All right, now we get Team of the Year cards. It's almost certainly going to be John Kuhn here. No, actually, you know what? Muhammad Wilkerson might be slower than Kuhn at an 80 speed. Let's go. Kuhn is an 81. All right, nice, because I didn't want to get the fullback. So we've got the two Jets defensive ends in Richardson and Muhammad Wilkerson. Pretty beast cards, though. These guys could actually do some damage for me on the defensive line, so that could be a lot worse. Obviously, Russell Wilson's a lot quicker than those guys. Okay, now back to the defensive side of the ball. We haven't gotten a defensive tackle yet, so I'm sure that's what we're going to be getting here. Jerry Hughes is quick. And Brandon Williams is only 64 speed. Obviously, Jimmy Smith in 88. It's going to suck, man, when I don't have any cornerbacks, but I did get a wide receiver at least. All right, so we've got a left guard already. We're not going to go with that. Cornerback is almost certainly going to be freaking Charles Tillman. 80 speed, dude. He's hardly better than the base guys that I have. Yikes. Yeah, it's got to be Tillman, unfortunately, because Virgil Green's got 87 speed. So, yeah, Tillman, I guess. Ugh. That's not a good pick, though. That is definitely not a good pick. All right. Where do we want to... Oh, cripes. All right, we've already got freaking four of the five offensive linemen. It's probably going to be this one here because we haven't gotten this position yet, the right tackle position. So 59 speed Chris Clark. Yeah, he's definitely going to be the slowest of this bunch for sure. So, all right. Well, we've got the offensive line out of the way. We've still got four more picks left and our legend round, so we don't have to pick a legend offensive lineman. That could be kind of helpful, actually. Let's see here. Now we go defensive line again. So we've already got a defensive end here, so we actually don't have to go with Fletcher Cox, which is nice. So now it comes down to Devin McCourty and Dominic Rogers-Cromartie, who are actually identical speed. So the tiebreaker is going to be acceleration, and it looks like Devin McCourty has lower acceleration at a 90, so we've got to go with him. But that's actually the best player on the board, so that's actually not too bad. Definitely like to see that. So, we're doing okay here. Now we might be going quarterback here because Matt Ryan is not quick at a 75 speed. And I know he's not going to be slower than Morgan Burnett or Steve Smith. So, all right, we've got our quarterback at least, too. We've got a good quarterback. We've got a good wide receiver in Andre Johnson. Offensive side of the ball, we're not really going to be too good, I don't think, because dear Lord, at our freaking running back position right now, it's going to be rough for sure. All right, we've got offensive linemen out of the way. All of the offensive line is already filled out. So now it's between Reggie Nelson and Eric Berry, although we already have a free safety. So I guess it's pretty much going to be Eric Berry here. He would actually be the slower player of the two anyway. So, all right, we're going to go with Eric Berry. So we've got two good safeties over the top to help out with Charles Tillman, who's just a joke. And then on the legend round, we are going to get some good players here. We have one defensive tackle. And, 49ers, I believe. I'm trying to remember off the top of my head. I believe that they run a 3-4, if I remember correctly. And I apologize if I get this incorrect. But we've already got a defensive tackle. So, I think that we're going to go with one of these two here. It's either going to be LaDainian Tomlinson or Lamar Woodley. And it looks like it's going to be Woodley because he is the lower speed of the two. Although, we already have a left outside linebacker too. So we've got a defensive tackle. I don't want to pick two. I'm trying to remember right now. I'm pretty sure the 49ers have a 3-4 still. So basically, guys, yeah, this is kind of interesting because I think we're going to just end up with LaDainian Tomlinson because we've already got a left outside linebacker. We've already got a defensive tackle. So, yeah, I guess we get LaDainian Tomlinson. That's kind of a bailout pick, honestly, because I was not excited about the offense that we had up to this point. So that's actually not too bad. We'll get Tomlinson, who was the fastest player on the board there for the final legend round, and he was the only player at a position that we didn't already have. So this is actually a decent draft. 84 overall. Could be a lot worse. I guess it's helpful that we got our offensive linemen out of the way. Not a bad team to start it off, guys. We're going to change up the lineup just a little bit here, make sure everybody's in there starting. I think they should be. But with that said, let's get into the first game. All right, guys, on offense to start this game off, got Matt Ryan at quarterback, LaDainian Tomlinson at running back. We've got Andre Johnson out wide, possibly going deep here if he's going to go. Yep, there we go. We're going to go deep here. Let's test him. Come on, Andre, be great. Let's go. The aggressive catch to start it off with Andre. Let's go. Big play on that first down, guys, on the first play of the game, making sure that he is going to remember that we're going to be able to take the ball and go deep if we need to. LaDainian up the middle there for a couple yards. All right, we got Michael Humanawanui at tight end, and he is just not very quick, so this is going to be a little bit rough, I think, but let's see here. We got Tomlinson in the flats, though. Tomlinson's going to be the main weapon on offense for sure right now for us, guys. First and 10, we're going to try and take it up the middle again here. He run committed last time, or actually, I don't think he run committed, but he definitely blitzed, and we're going to take it outside here. Nice big gain here. LaDainian with the spin move, nearly getting lost there on the defense. That would have been huge. He's brought a couple of blitzes in a row now, so hopefully we can find somebody open here. I'm assuming Beasley's going to be open in the flats, but we'll see. Yep, he's wide open in the flats. Beasley, get into the end zone, Pimp. Let's go. Touchdown on the first drive, baby. Let's go. All right, first and 10 here. My opponent on offense now. And I have to remember that I've got to try and keep guys over the top so that I don't get beat deep. That's one thing that I am super concerned about in this game right now. He's got Marshall Faulk at running back too, so he can do some damage on the ground. This is going to be tough on defense for sure. Let's do this. Okay, short pass. Ah, he got me. Good play. Good play. Good play. Good tackle. Let's go. Nice. Could be another run here. Nope, he is going to pass. Going Jimmy Graham here. Oh, send him on the tackle. Let's go. Sent the man and he got him. Good stuff, Justin Houston. We put him in a QB spy there because I thought for sure that he would try and scramble out. This guy just seems like one of those types of players that would try and scramble out every single time. And he did. And we were able to make the play. So very, very nice there. Now we can pass commit a little bit here. And we'll see what we can do. And it looks like, all right, I got stuck on a defensive lineman. But it's going to bring up a fourth and short here, probably about a fourth and five. Looks like he is going to go for it here. Set Quinton Cobles into a QB spy. Come on. Don't you run it up the middle with Faulk. Don't you do it. He's going to. Do we stop him anyways? Let's go. Let's go. Huge stuff by Eric Berry there. Coming up and making a big play. And it looks like my opponent is going to rage quit. Definitely love to see that. So we'll do one more game, guys. Good start, though. We got the first W. All right, guys, opening play of the game here. Inside zone by my opponent, of course. Starting things off on the ground. Not a bad pickup for him, but certainly not a lot to be worried about yet. So my opponent does have Vic, which means that I'm going to have to stop the run here for sure with the quarterback. We're pretty much going to spy every single play, I'm assuming. So, yeah, and there he goes, picking up a big gain there. I think that's Ryan Matthews. Is that who that is? Yeah, so it's going to be something where I have to watch these running backs out of the backfield, still have a spy on Vic. It's going to be a little bit difficult, but we're going to try and do it. All right, probably going to be a run here with Matthews to the left, I would assume. Nope, he's going out. We're passing it here. Nice pickup there for him. He's moving the ball pretty effectively down the field so far. Hasn't really scrambled yet with Vic. So maybe I can get away with not committing on the quarterback, but we'll see. It's probably going to be some ground game here. Matthews maybe carry to the left here. Let's see. Nope, pass again. Ah, dang, he's getting his guys open. Got to force a fumble or something here, man. So far, we definitely do not have the speed to keep up with Vic here, which has been a little bit tough. So I don't know what's going to happen. Got the blitz in there, but it didn't really get to him quick enough, and he was able to hit a guy in the flats. So he's definitely moving the ball effectively here on his first drive. This is going to be a tough game, I think. Got to make him throw a pick. Come on, give me one pick. Let's go, Eric Berry. Eric Berry, who made the big play on fourth down in the previous game, gets the interception here, and we're looking pretty damn good right now. All right, so it's my turn now to take over on offense. Hopefully, we can move the ball down the field effectively here. And it looks like he's running just a simple two-man under, and we are able to pick up the first down there with a nice pass by Matt Ryan. Actually, it was a QB or a cover one there, but it was man-to-man coverage, so simple to make that read for the most part. All right, we got to watch out for the nano blitzes here. This guy's setting some weird stuff up. Got him. Let's go. Michael Humanao Anui. Not really known for being a quick receiver, but he does pick up a big first down for us down the field there. Cover one again by my opponent, just completely murdered by the passing game. So nice little pickup for us there. And now we're going to try and pick something up on the ground here. A little run up the middle, hopefully, with Tomlinson. He's still bringing a lot of guys to the line. Yeah, we're able to get some blocks here, too. Looking pretty good on offense so far. So my opponent's ran a lot of man-to-man coverage so far, but I think he's going to try and mix it up here with a pass. We'll see, though. Or with zone coverage. He doesn't, but we've got a man still wide open. That's Cole Beasley, and he is going to break it away to the end zone for the touchdown. Let's go. My opponent played his user pretty well there, but we had a guy wide open on the left. He's run a lot of man-to-man coverage, and as long as he's going to do that, we should be able to make some pretty easy reads for the most part. So we ran a lot of man coverage last drive and then mixed it up with his zone, and he didn't see it coming. I think he's probably going to start off running the ball here. Nope, he is going to pass. Oh, man. We nearly got beat deep there. That would have been disgusting. But he is going to pick up a big gain there on first down. Nice play by him. All right, he's going five wide now. I gotta try and cover the middle of the field myself here, I think. Oh, good play by him there. Good play. Come on, Houston. I gotta try and pick up like a big hit on him or something. This guy's moving the ball really effectively on offense right now. It's very difficult to stop when he's got so many weapons. Let's go! Give me that pick! What the f- Come on! That is the easiest user pick. Give me a break. I am pissed. That is absolutely disgusting that that wasn't an interception. Wow. Come on, man. You gotta give me a break there. Another one that should have been a pick. You've got to be joking. Two in a row that should have been intercepted. User picked. Come on. All right, so I think my opponent's probably going to try and throw short here on fourth and five. So I'm actually going to set quite a few guys into coverage here, and hopefully we can make the play. There it is. Let's go, Charles Tillman. Big tackle. Keeping him short of the first down. We might get another rage quit here, potentially. Nope, does look like he's going to stick in the game, at least for now. So we make the nice stop there on fourth down again. Nice, nice drive-ending play by our defense there. We let up yardage. Bend but don't break. Let's go. We're back on offense now. Got to try and move the ball through the air, I think, here. That's the move. Andre's so naked. Let's go, Andre. Get into the end zone, buddy. Get into the end zone. Get on that horse. Oh, he almost made it. If we had a little bit quicker guy, we could have gotten in the end zone there, but the speed definitely played a factor. We did pick up a nice first down there. Huge, huge gain down to the 2-yard line. We're going to try and problem right this here and fullback dive it into the end zone. We'll see. Looks like he's got guys there, but we're still going to run it anyways. Get in there. Let's go. The fullback dive for the touchdown. 14-0 lead early in this one. Looking very, very good on both sides of the ball. Let up quite a few yards on defense, but we've gotten an interception and a fourth down stop. So 14-0, definitely looking good right now. Moving with the defensive tackle here. Didn't mean to do that. He threw it right at my guy again, and we didn't get a pick. That's, what, three picks now that our guys have dropped? Granted, that was like a defensive end, but still. He's definitely flustered right now, so hopefully we can still stop him. I'm expecting four verts here, so I'm going to try and cut this this running back off route right here, but we'll see. Yeah, he's going to throw it here. Nope, he's going deep, and he's got him. He's got him. Charles Tillman just could not get there in time. Damn it, man. We had a guy over the top, I thought, but apparently he decided to go and cover somebody else. So easy first down for him there. Charles Tillman just cannot keep up with DeAndre Hopkins. So my opponent is probably feeling a lot better about his offense right now after that completion. But I'm assuming a run is coming here, and it is. We do run a run defense, and it didn't work out, but we still made the play. Only a 5-yard gain there, not too bad. Hurry up offense by my opponent now. Got to try and cut something off here, maybe get another user or a user pick here. We haven't gotten one yet, but there it is. Big sack there by our defensive line. Didn't really make a loss there, but still a big stop there. Make him a little bit worried about running the ball with Vic, I think. All right, let's do this, guys. Come on. Let's make the play. Come on. Nobody's going over the middle. Nobody's going over the middle. Oh, nice play in the flats. Possession catch, though, is going to bring up a fourth down. This is going to be interesting now. We've got a fourth and two here. We'll see if he's going to try and take off with Vic. I'm actually kind of expecting that, but we'll see what happens. I don't think a run is coming here. I don't think he's got the guts to run it. We'll see. I'm pass committing, though. If he runs, he runs. Throw it. Throw it. Let's go! Good play by our defense, and we get another fourth down stop. I'm assuming that the rage quit's going to come if we score here on this drive. So we've got a minute 28 to get down the field and potentially take over this game and get the W. All right, could be a deep ball here if he's got single coverage again. I'm going to quick move my offensive lineman there, try and cover that. Yep, there it is. We're going deep. Screw it. Get it, Andre. Be great. Oh, and he gets the pick. Wow. What luck. What luck on that one, man. Come on. I don't get user picks. I don't even get user picks, but he gets a diving interception with his safety. Come on, man. Give me a break. So my opponent's got new life on offense now, disgustingly enough. I can't believe it. But a minute 17 still. He's got to drive all the way down the field. It's going to be tough for him. And he throws it into the flat, into coverage there against my corner, and he just doesn't make the play for some reason. That was disgusting. Come on. Guys, we got to make plays. We can't just let him throw it right where we are and not intercept it. Come on. He's throwing it deep into coverage here. Come on, guys. And he gets it. Oh, he dropped it. My goodness. He threw it into double coverage, and my guys didn't stop it. Oh, come on. He wants it all right now, man. He is going deep. He is definitely looking deep. But we're keeping that contain on Vic and not letting him pick up the big yardage. And all right, he's going to go with a nice screen there. Good call there on third and short. Didn't have our guys into position, but that's all right. We're still keeping him. We're still playing it smart, I feel like, to be honest with you. I'm not too worried about that play. Now we're setting our guy in coverage there on the running back. He's going deep again here. Come on, ball. Come on, dude. Second time he's thrown it up into coverage and gotten the pick, or gotten the catch, I mean. So, all right, first and goal from the one. This is probably going to be a touchdown. All right, let's rush everybody again, man. Screw it. Be great, guys. Come on. QB sneak here. Yep, QB sneak, and he does get in that time. Ugh, that's so frustrating that we threw that pick and then gave up two deep aggressive catches. But it is what it is, man. That's Madden this year. Now, we do get the ball to start off the second half, but I'm a little bit frustrated right now that we don't have a bigger lead than this. It should be at least a 14-0 lead, if not a 21-0 lead. And LaDainian Tomlinson is off to the races, ladies and gentlemen. Spin move, see ya! Let's go to the end zone. Tomlinson for the score. Big play there on the first play of the second half. Tomlinson goes all the way. Our fastest player on offense, I think. Definitely the most explosive player for us, though, and we get the big touchdown there on first down. So definitely love to see that. Was frustrated going into the second half, but now we're looking pretty good again with the 14-point lead. And guys, yes, I am running quarters defense right now because I want to try and get some speed on the field, even in running situations like this, just because I just don't think that it makes a whole lot of sense to not. And there it is, the deep ball, despite the fact that we ran cover four. Somehow it's just ass naked, wide open. I don't even know what to say about that. There should have been a safety right there, but apparently not. That is disgusting. Let's go, the user pick! Eric Berry coming out of nowhere to get the pick. Let's go! Eric Berry, another turnover forced, his second interception of the game. Huge, huge play defensively. I saw that thing developing, and I was just able to get there just barely in time. Back on offense now. Got to try and keep moving the ball here and take the lead by a bigger margin. We've got Andre open. Let's go. Right over the middle, Andre Johnson making another nice grab. 7-for-9 right now, Matt Ryan is. The one interception that we threw is obviously a tipped pass, so not too bad for Matt Ryan right now. He's looking pretty good and effective for us. We're going to try and run it on the ground here with Tomlinson again, though. We got good blocking last time we ran this play. We'll see if it happens again. No, that was not good blocking at all. Looked good at first, but it definitely broke down. The block shedding got there that time. Yeah, he run committed there basically by a blitz up the middle, so that makes sense. All right, 3rd and 12. This hasn't been the best drive, so we'll see if we can get another receiver open here. 3rd and 12, he's been running a lot of man coverage. Get it, Tomlinson. Be great. All right. It's going to be 4th and short, and I think we've got to go for it here. We've been really effective moving the ball, and 4th and short really gives us a lot of opportunities to do a lot of different things. I think I'm going to be able to get open and make a pass, so we're definitely going to go for it here. This should be somebody getting wide open, but I don't know, man. I don't like that he's got this defense set up like this, but he was offside, so we're just going to throw it deep here. We've got a man wide. Humanawanui wide open over the middle, and that is a huge gain. I don't know why he's running fullback defense or field goal defense there, but definitely a good play for us there. Big pickup, setting us up in field goal position to go up 3 scores here. Definitely loving to see that. 2nd and 19, and we're out of field goal position now after that sack, unfortunately, so we've got to try and do something. Oh no, he brought the heat on us there. Damn it, man. Come on. You got to be kidding me. I can't believe that we're in 3rd and 30 now after we were in such a good situation. We're probably just going to have to chuck it up deep here and hope that something good happens. We'll see. Got Andre. Single coverage. He's got this, dude. He's got it. Touchdown. Let's go. I don't know what he's doing, leaving one guy over the top for both sides of the field. Andre Johnson easily into the end zone for the TD there. Gotta love it, man. Let's go. Cover one QB contain. I haven't ran the ball once with my quarterback. Don't know why he's running contain. Another run here, I'm assuming, but I'm all right with that. Totally all right with that if he wants to run. And we hit him in the backfield. Come on. That should have been a big stop. Come on. I don't know what he's doing. He's wasting a hell of a lot of clock running the ball. Yeah, he's moving the ball, but he's down three scores. He's got to get points on the board, man. We've got guys everywhere, and we get the sack. The defensive line coming through. Muhammad Wilkerson with the big play. The man up three deep's been working on this drive. I'm not really worried too much about him taking off with Vic right now. And I don't know what he's doing, only having four guys on the field to catch passes. Like, this is not a good decision. He does make the nice grab there, but yeah, I mean, dangerous, dangerous plays for him. I don't know why he's got tight ends on the field. Like, that's going to be the guys to throw to. I don't know what he's thinking here. Throw it. Yep, right over the middle. Right to my guy. Big play there by Fletcher, and that will pretty much wrap things up here. I'm assuming the rage quit still hasn't come, so this guy's sticking in till the end, I guess. Gotta give him credit for sticking through till the end, although in Draft Champions, I'm not really sure why you do it, but still. I mean, gotta game-recognize game, I guess. So we're back on offense. My opponent's starting to use his timeouts. I'm just trying to run out the clock here, but you know, if he wants to do that, that's totally fine with me. I don't know why he's running out or not just letting me run out the clock here. Three scores, under 2 minutes left. There's no way in hell he can score that many times. He should just give up right now, but he's not going to. We're just going to continue to run the ball. And we are going to finally force the rage quit. I don't know what the hell took him so long. I guess he was just desperate to try and score one more time, but at the end of the day, though, guys, I can play with guys that are slower. We don't always have to draft the fastest players is, I guess, the point of this video. Muhammad, whatever the hell his name is, Humanawa Nui, Brandon, whatever the hell his name is, I don't even know. I think that's how you pronounce it, but he made some big plays for us down the field at the tight end position. He is not known for making big plays in the receiving game. So, yeah, speed. It's important, but it's not the most important thing. So that is going to do it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, do me a favor. Go ahead and click that like button below. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I will talk to you guys again soon.